Finally, we now get an update on the Women's World Cup in France from our very own Steve Hopper.
Welcome back to another edition of Adopted by the Lionesses World Cup Editions. I've been thinking about the comparisons that we draw between men and women's football. Now, we are told that it would be important not to draw the comparisons between the men and the women's game. I can understand why, but it is difficult if you've been following, like myself, the men's game all your life and you haven't watched too much women's football. So I think it's important to study the differences between both sets of international teams. So for instance, if we look at Argentina in the men's game, a dominant force, they will always be, at least at the minute, a force to be reckoned with in the World Cup, favourites to lift that trophy. On the flip side, in the women's game, if you adopt that same approach, you're not going to get the same results. Argentina have never won a women's World Cup game. They've lost all previous six matches, only been to two World Cups. Yesterday, they drew 0-0 with Japan. That was their first draw in the World Cup, and that's a tremendous result for Argentina. And Japan, not favourably looked at in the men's World Cup, but one of the favourites to win the World Cup this year over in France. So it would be worth looking at the differences between both international sides and all international sides and the rankings across the World Cup international teams.
Amy, you play for Lewis.
Yeah.
How is things going at Lewis at the minute?
Well, obviously we're in off-season at the moment.
Yeah.
But we do get season plans and stuff just to keep us sort of ticking over, nothing too drastic.
Yeah.
But obviously it's we're gearing up for the new season, which is looking promising. Obviously going to be our second season in the championship. And I think for the club that is huge, and I really hope that this year we get to push on and do even better than we did last year.
It's about stabilising yourselves in the championship really at this stage, isn't it? It's about making sure that you're high above that relegation zone.
Yeah.
What place did you finish this season?
So we finished, what was there, 11 teams, so we finished 9th
yeah.
out of 11.
Which isn't bad considering the type of club Lewis is. And
For the first season
in
the championship we did do really, really well. So we had a great start to the debut season in the championship, and then from there it sort of didn't completely go downhill, but it just sort of petered out a little bit, and we didn't really do as well as we could have. And then obviously halfway through the season we got the manager in and everything changed from there as well. So obviously this season we get to start fresh with the new manager, and hopefully from there we can sort of pick on and sort of make it as well.
What are your aspirations going forward in your career?
My career is probably nearly over at the sprightly age of 27, but I would love to be able to say that I've played professional football. Obviously at this age it's highly unlikely, but
you've still got years left, and with the way that the science is moving forward and allowing players to play for longer at the minute, because it's being able to target specific areas of your body, specific areas of your play, which allows you to continue in a way that's never been happened before, because it was a lot of guesswork in the old days of, well, how do you feel, let's run it off, let's put you out there and train you in pre-season, and basically just run until your legs drop off, whereas now you can be very targeted and specific about what you can do well with all these methods and improve the areas that you need to improve to help you sustain a career for a lot longer.
Yeah, so obviously with that now, even though you may think it's you're nearing the end, obviously there may be a few years in us yet. Obviously it's moving forward, obviously with the growth of women's football as well, it does give you a lot more time to be a part of it. So obviously where things are developing, it may be that I could eventually in the next couple of years play professional football. Obviously it's always been an aspiration ever since I was started football at the age of 9, so yes, it's always been there. So it's just a case of trying to get those last legs through and see it through, hopefully.
Fingers crossed. I wish you all the luck. And thanks very much for talking to me today, Amy.
Thank you very much.
Thanks.
Thank you.